everyone. This is Derek. Making my final report on the events at Harper's Ferry. Hopefully this reaches you all safely. Whatever happened here, it was big. The whole area is... It's devastated. If any of our people survived, I can't find a trace of them. I talked to some of the locals. They say creatures came from the sky. Laid waste to the town. Some of the ones who got hurt in the attack were transformed or something. They apparently turned into monsters and attacked anyone they could reach. Riley says he and his people are gonna seal themselves up in their bunkers and try to figure out a way to fight these creatures. In other words, we won't be getting any more help from these Free States guys. Maria, I was hoping you could get in touch with Ella. See if maybe she can lean on Riley a little. Up to see that this isn't the way. If you ask me, I think it's damn selfish of them to turn their backs on the rest of us. People who need their help to survive. There's nothing else I can do here. Guess we can scratch Harper's Ferry off the map. I'll be heading back soon. But I want to check in on some of the farms along the way. Should be about a week.
All right, we're recording. Good. Because now, we can get on record that I think this idea is goddamn loony. I'm not thrilled about sending our people into a place that's actively toxic either. But there are whole towns down there we still haven't reached out to. Welch, Beckley, Bramwell. Bramwell? Come on now. You really think the Hornrides or the Garahans didn't fly off to some private island the moment the air raid sirens turned on? Most likely they did. But right now we don't know and don't have a safe way of finding out. And that's why I wanted your help, Melody, on how we can get there. Fine. We got a couple of folks from the Charleston Fire Department. I can talk to them. See what they have to say about getting set up for those sorts of operations. Thank you. Anyone you send into all that smoke is gonna need training, though. Smart if they're gonna survive someplace that hostile. And breathing equipment's finicky as hell. A whole lot of care and maintenance if they're gonna be out there for hours, let alone days. You're talking about a whole new division here.
I understand what I'm asking.
Tell you what you ought to do. You ought to give them a name.
A name?
Green Berets, Smoke Jumpers, Navy SEALs. You want someone to sign up for dangerous duty, there needs to be some prestige behind it.
Hey, everyone. This is Derek. Making my final report on the events at Harper's Ferry.
All right, we're recording. Good. Because now we can get on record that I think this idea is goddamn loony.
I'm not thrilled about sending our people into a place that's actively toxic either. But there are whole towns down there we still haven't reached out to. Welch, Beckley, Bramwell.
Bramwell? Come on now. You really think the Hornrides or the Garahans didn't fly off to some private island the moment the air raid sirens turned on?
Most likely they did. But right now we don't know and don't have a safe way of finding out. And that's why I wanted your help, Melody, on how we can get there.
Fine. We got a couple of folks from the Charleston Fire Department. I can talk to them. See what they have to say about getting set up for those sorts of operations. Thank you. Anyone you send into all that smoke's gonna need training, though. Need to be whip smart if they're gonna survive someplace that hostile. And breathing equipment's finicky as hell. A whole lot of care and maintenance if they're gonna be out there for hours. Let alone days. You're talking about a whole new division here.
I understand what I'm asking.
Tell you what you ought to do. You ought to give them a name.
A name?
Green Berets, Smoke Jumpers, Navy SEALs. If you want someone to sign up for dangerous duty, there needs to be some prestige behind it. You give them a name, a new designation, extra rations maybe. I'll guarantee you get the volunteers you're looking for.
Any suggestions?
Huh. Well, Gramps was a moonshiner. Made hooch so strong normal folk couldn't come within a quarter mile of it. Everyone called him and his boys the fire breathers. The zillions of the guns. What about that?
I suppose we don't need to go with the first idea we come up with. But for now, I'd like you to reach out to those firemen. Convince them to get on board with the fire breathers. Let them know it's important. Prestigious.
Oh, Lordy. I think she likes it.
I'll work on getting them a place to train. Charleston Fire Department seems like the natural spot.
Certainly won't have to travel far to get yourselves into trouble.
Good. We should get started. If there's anyone still alive down there, I think they've suffered enough.
Responder Survivors Volunteer Program. Advanced Training. Camping. By Miguel Caldera. Robot Programmer Extraordinaire. Part 1. Finding the perfect camping location. Now that the world has changed, it's hard to stay safe. Used to be that camping was safe as houses. Well, until there was a strong wind, right? These days, nothing is really safe. Even in your camp, someone might hurt you. The perfect spot doesn't matter now. It's all about your defenses. You can build near people you trust who will watch your back, or build things that will watch your back for you. No problem. Anyone can do it. Remember, camps are mobile. We're all explorers now. Camping in a strange land full of adventure, wonder, and danger. So, camp often, and rest a lot. Before the war, I was gonna retire and go camping. Now I can do it every day. Forever. It's a dream come true. What you love, right? Now come to my camp, and I can show you some knots and framing techniques. Then, I'll direct you onto some helpful supplies. Good luck, volunteer.
Hi.
Together.
This is Logan. Is your mic plugged in?
Well, yeah, now it's plugged in, and Logan, my brother, leave the stream.
Hi. Never.
Well, if so, then just stop commenting because I'm trying to focus on this game.
Again, never. I am watching your gameplay, plus you need to talk more.
Attention all responders. This is a top priority message. Radar has spotted an inbound cargo bot. We've got to secure the landing zone so we can take the drone. We need those supplies, but the cargo bot's going to attract attention, so get ready for a fight.
Good job, you did it. TLZZ talk more and I will stop commenting if you do it.
Comments from doing anything, and no, I don't plan on talking that much because I just don't feel like it. But what I do want to say is there's a level 50 Scorch Beast nearby that I saw appear. I do not want to fight it. Also, don't bother commenting, it won't let me see it. Ha.
Boy emoji rolling on the floor laughing.
Ugh! now on final approach. Eyes to the sky, people.
cleaning products. I would. This monument deep in the wooded heart of... the heart of the Appalachian countryside, overlooking majestic Grafton Lake. Grafton Lake? I can't read my own writing. I hate these last-minute changes. Kelly raised the 1st West Virginia and became its colonel in May of 1861. Later, in June, at the Battle of Philippi, he was severely wounded. I like to think that the colonel would have used Abraxo cleaning products. You can learn more about the Battle of Philippi at the Philippi Battlefield Cemetery. I can't wait to see you there.
Okay. I think that went pretty well. Oh, long day. Lunch here yet?
Mayor here. We have a catastrophe on our hands. The very expensive cricket sport renovation has hit a snag. I need that attraction to open without any bad press. Apparently, they found the remains of a Civil War soldier during construction. Well, probably from the Civil War. It's from somewhere, that much I'm certain of. Let's just all agree it's a Civil War soldier, shall we? Anywho, someone needs to give those remains a nice, anonymous burial in Philippi Battlefield Cemetery. And by someone, I mean you.
You must be from the archaeological preservation. I have a real problem. Soldier, although the body is highly irradiated, strangely fresh. Looks like it died a year ago instead of 2 hours.
Cricket's fort was surrounded by This is a typical colonist barracks. Housed on average 14 soldiers.
Confederate guns are thin and weak. Union guns are straight and chic.
Confederate soldiers have
soldiers drink Nuka-Cola. Get yourself a refreshing Nuka-Cola now! Confederate soldiers have... dump coats!
Towers were used to monitor the area around the fort.
Watch your step on the catwalk.
Those remains need a proper burial.
Although they seem awfully fresh for a Civil War soldier.
Thank you.
settlement meetings.
That's
all. Colonists would also gather here for settlement meetings.
You want to be a Union soldier? Then get in there and defend that fort. Let's go, Union!
This is a typical blacksmith shop, where blacksmiths would make horseshoes, various tools, and perform routine repairs by hand.
Strangely well preserved, as if they were only a couple of decades old. But that can't be.
Dick Shale here, welcoming you to Brickettsport.
eliminated.
stick, up, hop, hop. Just kidding. Want to buy or sell? Get your raiding supplies here or don't. I don't care. Reminder, any attempted five-finger discounts will be reclaimed and paid for with said fingers. Caps available in exchange for pillaged loot. Pillaged loot available in exchange for caps. You looking at me? How about you stop looking and start buying? This vendor unit is equipped with anti-theft measures. Don't get any ideas, chump. Do not make any further escape attempts. Long.